What? Good evening. This is Cat's Face. I'm Cat. This is Buckets. Tonight with us are Amanda and Leon. We sans Aaron. Hope you are watching Aaron. We love you and miss you. This is a special royal edition in regards to the royal coronation. First of all, may we please say congratulations to their majesties, to His Majesty King Charles III. On his coronation, God save the king. Now let's begin our reaction video.
There's
Let's do this.
God save my wallet as well.
Yeah.
Out there, God save my wallet and
God
all.
save the podcast.
And what this is basically an edition of basically Gogglebox, but with cat space. So
Can't say
basically,
that.
for
They're going
this,
to
we're going
sue
to
us.
call this Cat's Box.
Yes.
Wait, there is no Gogglebox. I mean, it's
Yeah.
there.
Yeah. According to our lawyers, we don't even know what
If
Gogglebox
you
is.
say it, if you say it three times, it appears like Rumpelstiltskin, so be careful.
Well, shall we start up?
Do
Yes.
this. Let's do
There are
this.
bonnets, there are union flags, as far as the eye can see.
The costumes and the souvenirs that people wear is absolutely amazing. Like, who's selling this stuff?
How are you?
The hell it is, the Monopoly guy.
Here we
This is the
go.
Parker Brothers.
About 13 hours come down from Leicester
If he
yesterday.
goes three steps forward, you know it's prison.
Here on the left side.
Believe in
Three
what I'm
steps
happens when you
back,
hold
and you
three
know it's
doubles, isn't
committed
it?
chest.
He did not pass go. He did not collect $200.
Fans, Leicester fans in the crowd, they said it's okay,
I
Leicester.
didn't even know the Parker Brothers were still alive.
Come down here today to enjoy the celebrations.
Oh my God, it's Charlie Chaplin, guys.
And
In the day.
the thing is, he's talking. That's the strange thing.
Back 1,000 years, William the Conqueror.
We love your work, Charlie. We love it.
Keep it going.
He can't hear us.
For you, I'll just come down here as well.
I love that he's wore a whole
Me there.
suit to meet the king, or if, not even to meet him, just for the king to drive past. He wore a whole suit.
I so desperately want to learn how to play the violin.
You can see
Very, very difficult.
the royal bed lamps, just to, and the
Oh,
he
this
was
is that
the
George
royal,
Bell.
the royal dancer, the royal
That's
Macarena.
George Bell,
Everyone
isn't it?
together. En dona cena, yeah, Macarena.
Yeah. That's a lot of bed lamps.
Here we go. Now, the conductor of this orchestra, I'm just gonna say, reminds me of the Mad Hatter quite a lot. He's just so eccentric with his movement.
He's so into.
Over here, everybody over here.
I'm surprised I'm here with you.
Oh, here we go.
Look at that regal car. I just love
FBI, FBI showing up. Here we go.
I think this is the UK's version of an Uber taxi.
He got a Uber pool to the coronation. He
Uber
got
royal car.
sorry, he got he got a garage pool.
This is government transport at its best.
I would love it if 15 clowns stepped out of that car.
Absolutely.
Why can't we have Rolls-Royce buses? They're getting ripped off.
Well, we don't technically have a king in this country, do we? He's not living here, so therefore,
No, he just got coronated.
no buses for you.
Line it with the shots here. Our first sight today on
He's got
Coronation.
Ooh.
He's just waving at us.
King Charles III.
The
Hang
king.
on, Charles.
Carry on, carry on.
Carry on, love.
Which was
Now
built
everybody line up to get inside.
first 50 years on the throne, and there was input from the Duke
Do
of
a donut, do a donut, do a donut.
Do that, this car could
Do a burnout. Do a burnout. Wait, do the donut. Do a donut. Do that
crowds.
donut. In The Simpsons, I got caught up in this roundabout and they were driving around that same roundabout
That's
for
right,
hours.
for like 5 hours.
Yeah, exactly. And he ended up hitting the royal carriage, if I remember right.
First movement.
The royal boot up the bottom.
Making its way from Clarence House to Buckingham
Oh,
Palace.
look at those gates, guys. Okay, they cost more than all of our lives combined. Let's just put it out there.
You're probably right about
How does that make you
that
feel? That gate costs more than you.
See
too.
They will be diamond
Have a look at how many military people are around that roundabout. Jeez.
fountain roundabout.
Here we go, back in the Abbey.
The Royal Colts is performing. Everyone, shush, please.
Did you say the Royal Colt?
Correct. I feel like he's inherently happy all the time. I don't know why, but
looks like Darren Hayes.
That looks like Darren Hayes from Savage
this
Garden.
This guy hasn't slept all night for sure.
Same with that guy in the background there.
The triplets. Yep. Sorry.
How can they be triplets? You've got two females and one man there. That looks like Danny Minogue.
I've been to cities that never fall down.
Where's Peter Allen when we need him?
Oh.
Oh, here we go.
Now you, now you, now you, you, you.
Ooh.
He's just like a hype man. Like, you're doing good. Yep, that's great, buddy.
It does sound pissed. I have to.
Everyone agree. Out. Everyone.
You get a car. It's like an episode of Oprah.
Maybe he's asking for a high five. Your Majesty.
Was that Adele? Was that Adele there? Wouldn't surprise me. Spot. Oh, yeah, and okay.
Oh, here we go.
Here comes Dracula. Here comes Dracula.
He actually paid extra for that forehead. Extra brain space.
And the hair as well.
Extra storage. 128 gig.
It's huge.
People of all faiths.
Yes, the royal judges are here.
Oh, look.
Hello.
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 Can you hear me? You're looking for.
I can see it in your eyes. I can see it in your smile.
Yeah, he's got one hell of a smile, hasn't he?
See Lionel Richard in.
Hello.
The pews.
I don't think he's
like, yes, I quite like the song. I quite like the song.
Fine organ.
Why is Lionel Richie singing for us? You don't get Lionel Richie unless you want him to sing. I mean.
Why, true.
Imagine playing the Hayes. What's that song? A Whiter Shade of Pale on that organ? Oh, Oina Gata De Vida?
The finest.
That would rule.
I really want to play
some dramatic. Do there, Leon.
A dramatic Phantom of the Opera ballad on it.
Oh, that baseball thing.
The opera is me.
What about playing that baseball thing?
A Baroque baseball just comes through, like.
Try to steal third. This
no, 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 the royal no, baseball. No. The king catches it. He's been crowned.
Take me out to the ball game.
They throw the crown, and he's got to catch it on his head.
Catch it on his crown. takes his crown off, just holds it that way, and the ball just goes right in.
Say this.
That lady needs to speak. Right.
As much as I love the decorum inside. I would have liked to have seen more colors instead of the boring penguin outfits.
Penguin outfits?
What can you argue with tradition?
And the bland colors the women are wearing. Like, I would like to see more pop of color.
That is not bland. Look at those guys. They look like they're in uniform. They look
the
like
the uniformed people are quite bland. But however,
display.
I think the guests did a really good job. They'll be coming up soon, the guests, but they did a really good job at filling out the dress code this year. What am I saying? For this coronation, they've done a really...
The royal fashion is telling which way it's going to go left or go right, turn right. No, he's using the hand signals quite well.
I have to say the military outfits are spot on and very beautiful and bright, but I think this is a great Met Gala look. And I think
they are there to do their job. They're not there to
side.
But you have to say it is a Royal Met Gala look. Everyone looks so stunning. Like none.
Here we go. Crazy.
Become the penguins again.
Oh, look at this guy's hair. It's doing just as much action as his hands are.
Oh my god, seriously.
Look at ants in his pants.
What's this guy on? Seriously.
He looks like my cousin. Whoa. There he is. There's my cousin again. Hello.
Everyone looks like your cousin.
Hey, he would dance a mean Irish jig. I'm just saying it right now.
It's like Brooksy. That guy looks like Luke Brooks in the background.
Oh, here we go. Mr. Bean. Mr. Bean lookalike. There he is.
There he is. He's there.
The Mr. Bean lookalike, guys. That's what I've been waiting for this whole night.
Like
wait until his face comes Teddy. Back. His face will come back.
Oh, yeah.
What do you reckon? We're just waiting for him to say Teddy.
He looks like a young Rowan Atkinson with a bigger forehead.
Oh, look at him go.
God, he's going to have a stroke any second.
But you know what? This seems something like out of Star Wars, like, or yeah. Super in the movie.
Oh, wouldn't that be great to play the Imperial March in Westminster Abbey?
And at the Westminster Abbey, they're playing this in the orchestra. Oh my God, here comes the
here he comes. Here comes Cinderella. Yes, Cinderella has arrived at the ball. She will be in there momentarily. Everybody, stand by. The Cinderella has arrived. I repeat, Cinderella has arrived.
Cue the pumpkin. Cue the pumpkin, everyone.
I believe inside that is Prince William, Princess Catherine, and their beautiful, beautiful children. And I have to give it up for her. She looked exquisite, and so did Prince William.
But that Catherine always looks good. I'm going to say it. She cannot go wrong. She could wear a paper bag, and she'd look great.
Exactly. Well, but might I say the Waleses are on point. Well done.
I feel sorry for these guys because it's raining.
Which will be given.
It's always raining.
That's well, I did hear point. That a lot of the servicemen and women and the horses were absolutely drenched.
That segment we can just see ready to announce the point where the salute is given for the king's departure from Buckingham Palace. But we have a little bit more time.
Buckingham Palace is absolutely huge.
Look at the architecture on that, guys. It's so amazing. Man.
So where do you find a bit of panelling?
I wonder how many ghosts haunt it, to be honest.
That's what I'm thinking, but you know what?
There's one for every window.
That's a lot of windows.
I've read, and I don't know if this is true or alleged, but I've read that this place, Buckingham Palace and Windsor, are both haunted.
Yeah, I've heard that too. There's apparently a lot of tunnels.
Massive scepter, man. Have a look at this massive scepter.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Wow, look at the scepter.
I wonder how much that weighs, to be honest.
Statue of Liberty? Do
you reckon he did weights for a month to be able to lift this bloody thing?
I'd just like to point out that that's traditionally meant to be a weapon, but who could carry that thing and use it as a weapon? Like, realistically.
Honestly. I've got an idea. What would happen is you throw it to your enemy and they'll just drop it because it's too heavy. Then
why do I feel like a wasp is following him?
But do you know what? That looks like something the Statue of Liberty would be holding.
Yeah.
And they will be followed within
but
a few
if
minutes.
You notice the gold thing he's carrying, that looks like something the Statue of Liberty would be holding.
It's legit. It looks like a very royal Olympic torch. That's what.
Two speakers' processions.
Here we go. Weapon Man and Bumblebee are arriving. Everyone stand by.
And a labor of love.
Oh.
Yeah, back over to Buckingham.
The earbuds are moving in.
Imagine cleaning your ears with those things.
The ants go marching one by one. Hurrah. Hurrah. Oh, that one got lost. That one. Oh, no, he's just doing a turn. All right.
Inlaid with wood.
Another military band right there.
Buildings and places with specific connections.
Now, these ones are amazing. Because of the physical movement and playing the instrument at the same time, I have so much respect for these. Like, so hard. So difficult. You're going to be out of breath. You've got to play on beat. You've got to walk and march on beat. You've got to do everything on beat. It would be so difficult to choreograph this. Hands off to them. Hats off. Sorry, not hands off.
Oh, hang on. Got a horse sitting in front of Buckingham.
Oh, that's a nice booty.
That booty.
You know what?
They now twerk it. Now twerk.
They have been rehearsing.
You want a horse to twerk?
It'll be nice. There it is.
I want a horse to work, not a horse to twerk, okay?
I have to say, they have been rehearsing this for months on end, morning, noon, and night, even in the middle of the night.
This would be rehearsed for years. This would be a daily thing that they rehearse. Everyone come together, you know, army bands come together. We're about to play together for an hour. They would do this every day. There's no way that they don't.
These men and women have been rehearsing constantly.
Look at that regal carriage and that man. Like, look at the.
I've got to say, big up to Princess Anne, Princess Royal.
Oh yeah,
the king's bodyguard. What a beauty!
We'll be wearing
the golden stick. Wow,
impressive. I'm gonna say it now. Princess Anne would have been a really great queen. Really great queen.
He opens Parliament in future. I can see the King's Equerry coming out there, Lieutenant Colonel.
Open Sesame. He's just like waiting. He's just like waiting to get inside.
Well, hurry up then.
I'll have a look how many people are lined up outside there. That's just outside Buckingham. That's crazy.
It's funny because they can't actually say hold your horses.
We
Land and its freedoms. As the Major General.
That one can't see. I'm not even gonna lie about that. 100% he can't see. I don't know why he's on a horse.
I've had this question in my mind for years and years and years since I was little. How do they see out of that big furry thing on their head?
Well, only the higher rankings get the one that cover their eyes further down. The ones that stand outside Buckingham Palace and the ones that are foot soldiers actually have a higher arch. I don't particularly know what it means, but I know that.
But that's so heavy, like, it's so sweaty underneath. Oh, my God, there's...
And you know what? And the thing is, I heard they're made out of real burr fur, which I really don't like.
Yeah.
Take place. It'll be the only time the king will sign...
I was wondering what His Majesty was wearing in his golden carriage.
You know what's funny? Yeah. Like, even if you're king and you're the queen, whatever, like, what is all this lavishness for? Like... Who are you trying to impress exactly? What's with all this gold?
It's been going since.
That's like saying 1,000 years ago that the king and queen had different rules, and then 100, 200 years later, the new king and queen updated those rules. Why can't they just update the rules? Like, we're in a new age. They should be adding.
Yes, but this is part of what people don't understand.
This is what evolution is.
Yeah, but this is what people don't understand is this is part of their 1,000-year tradition. This has been going since,
and that's what I'm saying. A thousand years ago, they would have done it differently. 500 years ago, they would have done it differently.
Think of Queen Elizabeth I, or think of King Richard II, or think of Queen Mary. Things like that. These have been part of their history, part of their tradition.
I understand a tradition. What I'm saying is, culture does not dictate this lavishness anymore. Back then, yes, but now, no.
The things on the move, the cards on the move now.
Pomp and pageantry and beauty. Look at it. Look at those uniforms, those red and gold. Oh my God.
It is beautiful, but I can't help but think about all the people that are struggling in the world. And then I see this and I think, fuck, like, how much did this cost?
Yeah.
What is the point of this? To look at one man. There's millions of people in the world, but we're going to worship one. What? One person, just one. Sorry about the other 6 billion. Yous aren't important. Only one person's important.
But do you know what? That this...
Like, I want to arrive at my coronation in a golden carriage.
Who doesn't?
I'll start saving, Luna.
Look at it this way, right? This is the coronation of our lifetimes. But then again, we could see King William release.
We will be around for that.
You know, I mean... I have to get up to Charles. He was really nervous yesterday. Like, you could tell the fear on his face and the stress.
He looked quite lost without his mum. I'll say it now. He looked very lost without her. And now that he realizes that he is his mum now. Do you know what I mean? He took that role on.
He is his mum. What's he had a sex change,
like,
has he?
You get what I mean, though. When he came out on the balcony, I really saw it in his eyes for the first time. He realized, like, I'm the matriarchy of the balcony now. He no longer was underneath somebody, and that was the first time when I saw in his eyes that he realized that.
This thing had to be worth more than Australia itself. And look how many horses there are. Imagine a polo match.
I'm amazed they can't race. I mean, if this was Australia, wow. I would have been putting bets on it by now.
Have you noticed they've got a few other nations' flags, but not ours? Where's
that? They've got the Australian flag in amongst that.
They have a few around, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Street liners made up of the house.
They would have all the Commonwealth nations there.
The Royal Navy, in which the King served for some time. The Royal Navy leading the street lining all the way up. The arch and through it, the Royal Marines.
How many thousands of people do you reckon there are in this bloody procession right now?
Apparently, from what I read, there were 4,000 military people.
Well, here we go. Some fellas starting to arrive now.
And then think about it. That's only a dent in the some fella. Here we go. The person that nobody wants to see. Here we go.
Oh, and it is a rare occasion.
Hey, look, you know what?
I really hate. Even though Harry published that book, I really hate that they did him dirty and made him come in with his group. Like, I'm not saying anything bad about the rest of them, but that one person in particular, why would they group Harry with him? Is what would be
why? Because these are his cousins.
These are the outcasts right now.
These are Princess Eugenie and Beatrice with their respected husbands. And he's had to come
in
alone.
It's good that Harry's there, I suppose. That's a good thing.
Yeah, look, I mean,
he looks like he's in good spirits, doesn't he?
That's the thing. This is the Harry we all know and love and adore.
I noticed he's wearing all these medals, you know, Aussie's top here.
Well, look at Andrew. I will not refer to him as Prince because he does not deserve that title. But look at Andrew. He's got all on his regalia as well.
Yeah, so, yeah, I noticed that too.
He was allowed under the king's and the queen's ruling to wear it, but he wasn't allowed to sit at the front part of the procession.
He looks like Dracula, and you know, he probably. I mean, like one of the few people that ever made it to the Epstein Island as well. So, let's a few more awards for that. It's true, isn't it? It's just not
okay. It's just the way that the world has ignored it and not brought up the list, not brought up anything about that. It's getting off topic here, guys, but it's not right. I'll say that much.
Wow, Harry's in there with a big smile.
Here we go.
Yep.
And looked amazing. And look amazing, didn't she?
Love the horses. You got to love the blue. The blue is
beautiful. It looks great. Again, probably cost $3,000 to make that one saddle.
Well, no, it costs $3,000 to buy the horse. You know, everything else.
It costs $10,000 to buy a horse.
There we go. Look at this. They're pulling up on the Obie now.
I don't know where you pulled $3,000 from, but that's little money. That's enough to feed them for 2 weeks.
Sorry, yeah. That's the tip you get from the horse. My apologies.
Yeah, you get the horse ear. That's it.
Shit cost, basically, but the horse itself, maybe.
Let's see if they can stop.
You get a picture of the horse for that much.
This is one thing you're going to learn at driving school. You know, see if it can stop right in the right spot. Let's see if it gets it right.
Hey, imagine. Hey, you've got to learn how to. You got to get your horse's license. Like.
Oh no! I have a shot. No.
Back it up a little bit. There we go.
Imagine hearing the beeps in the background. Beep, beep, beep.
they just make it with their mouth.
And we are standing by for part two of this, by the way.
All righty.
Now, we noticed that there are people actually watching this as we're recording this, and we would just like to say thank you very much for your support. And but I would appreciate it if you just stopped texting right now because we're in the middle of recording. Thank you.
Sons are here to support him along with other senior royals and family members. By his side, Queen Camilla. We were told that the Queen wanted her to be known as Queen Consort.
She wanted to be known as the Consort.
That's what she should be.
Known as Queen Camilla. A lot of effort has been put into her robes. Amanda Wakeley is here with me. It's been designed, we believe, the dress.
Yeah, a bit of Harry right there.
Robes. Not sure what it's going to look like as yet.
Okay, so that is just part one of them arriving up to
part two
Abbey.
Coming up.
Yeah, right after the break on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Stand by.
All right, here we go. So we're going to part two of this thing now. I hope you guys are enjoying our instant reactions, by the way. We're having a ball, just laughing at each other.
Yeah. Hang on.
Suspended
inside Westminster Abbey. There we go. That looks like a painting, doesn't it?
old oil painting.
Yeah.
That moves.
A Picasso of some sort. What are they holding in their face? Some sort of white paper?
Are they trumpets or what are they called?
Oh, they are trumpets. Okay, I thought they were holding a piece of paper in the front of their face.
And they're royal trumpets or something.
It looks like an emoji.
From what I heard about the Welsh cross is that it has a small piece of the wood from our Lord's cross in there.
Miller,
symbolize his anointing or his crowning.
Magnificent, Amanda.
Oh, here we go. They're both out there.
Cinderella's coming in. Here we go.
And attended by her.
Now, I'm just going to point out, when I first watched this, I will not lie, I thought that haircut was so close to Diana, and I'm looking at it and I'm like, is this a joke? Is this some sort of a...
Yeah, it's a huge Tottenham Hotspur fan.
Very much tripped me out.
I'm interested that she's actually wearing white when she's technically not a virgin. But
ceremonial robes, Philip.
Have a look at that crown.
Charles is wearing white too, you'll see.
You'd be wearing dark after this.
Head.
was made for.
Don't fall.
Imagine someone throws a banana peel out the floor.
It does look like a Christmas pudding.
Marbles.
Oh, marbles.
Hair extensions. No.
Next thing you know, it's just starting to juggle a thing. Oh, hold it.
Do you think you make a replica of two swords for all of us to try?
Now, here we go. If we have a look at some of the outfits that some of the women have worn from especially different countries, they look spectacular. They put in, look at that lady in the pink hat. So much effort went into it. Look at this lady in the blue. Lovely. Absolutely beautiful.
The lady with the scepter, she looks gorgeous.
How's the other fellas dressed in black here?
Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
I was glad.
People actually look better than the king.
I actually thought it was funny how they walk them in. Like, they look like they're toddlers walking them into kindergarten.
Have a look at the guy's carpet. It looks bigger than me whole freaking hallway.
I would have been very tempted to jump on.
Carpet. I'm telling you guys, it's a flying carpet.
Everybody jump on. Here we go.
I could show you the world.
He's old, mate. Coming in now.
It's Jasmine, finest, everyone.
In his finest robes.
Queen Camilla and God save.
Looks like he's wearing my kind of robe. See, look, but I'm dressed in black. See,
I'm wearing a nice carpet, black robe.
They walk like my nonna used to walk.
I have to give it up to His Royal Highness Prince George. What a cutie patootie. Look how he's just made his grandfather so proud.
I think he did a really great job, actually. No, but the thing is, this is a first-hand experience for him for what he's going to experience in two cycles from now. He will experience it one more time when he's a bit older with his father, and then he will experience it himself. And this is a good learning curve for him to know what the day holds.
Yeah, you're probably right.
That's why they put him as a page boy, because he could be so close to the grandfather and shadow him for the day.
The royal carpet moves.
The royal ponytails followed by the royal carpet. Followed by more royal ponytails.
You reckon it'd be a bundle of nerves. You've been preparing for this for 50-something years.
At least he's warm. What can I say?
17.
Oh, yeah. It's bloody freezing out here. You reckon I could send some of those robes our way? Well, that lady nearly fell over.
This is a great angle. We can see everything.
What a... Like the height of the Westminster Abbey, I think it's about 100-something feet.
There was one stage when he walks in when he nods at one person, but he realizes he wasn't meant to do that, so he takes the nod away, and it was like...
Nobody saw that.
It was the most subtle nod I've ever seen in my life.
Don't worry, you've still got an awkward kiss still to come on this.
This is how my first day of school went.
Well, like this.
Yeah.
With them chanting boy band.
I had two people walk me in, and there was a choir singing, "Hallelujah, it's your prep day."
That wasn't just security, Luna. That wasn't.
I have to say, after all of this, I have a lot of love and respect for His Majesty. I think his reign is going to be a lot of fun. I think he's going to be a great king. I think he's going to be a great king.
Now, there's the flags, as you saw to the right just then. That was all the flags. Camilla doesn't even know what day it is. I'm sorry to say
Here's the script. Here's what you need to say.
I know they're not meant to smile and they're meant to keep a serious face, but she just looked like she wasn't even there. She looked like she was daydreaming, man.
That book looks like it's the hungry little caterpillar. That's what that looks like.
Poor little Charlotte. You could tell that she hates standing still. You can just see it in her eyes, and she just tries so hard to please her mum and dad. Good little girl, but... here we go. This is right.
He's obviously come in best dressed.
He said, "Your Majesty, we are here to something, something." That's right.
How about that? A kid tell off the king, man. That's a bonus.
No, he didn't tell him off. He said he accepted him into the church, and then King Charles accepted him as well.
Imagine if Charles said GTFO. That would be mad. Hallelujah.
Christ is... Oh, this guy. All right. I'm sorry to say, this guy reminds me of Praying Mantis. Okay, I thought about it the whole time. Couldn't stop seeing it after I thought that.
I like that. They say Christ is risen. Everybody's sitting down now.
Christ has risen, everyone says.
Have a look at this, right? He's looking at, yeah, you all better be sitting down, otherwise I'm not continuing on.
He's like, you sat down, bro?
That guy's vest looks like he wears that at laser tag.
Ooh, some baritones.
Nice.
Is this Meatloaf?
The reason why he said Christ is risen, don't forget we are still in the Easter process. There's like 3 or 4 Sundays of Easter or 5 Sundays of Easter after still.
Hey, check this out, mate. Meatloaf's still alive.
They say it also because...
Not alive, seriously.
When you pledge Batman in a black the church, tie. When you pledge to become king, you also pledge to the Church of England.
I just wait for this guy to start singing Bat Out of Hell or something. Baritone.
Who's this soprano singing right now? What's going on here? Why is he in a suit? Where's his uniform?
I don't know, but he's got high blood pressure. Have a look at
his face. Definitely going to pass out in a
second. Yeah, this guy's definitely had
cholesterol's through the roof, guys.
Yeah. He's definitely had an English breakfast, this one.
He's had a few of them.
His voice is spectacular.
I doubt what that you're voice. Watching, but if you're watching, we love your voice. We're very sorry for our jokes.
But I know you've had hash browns.
Round and round the circle like a teddy bear.
Where's Pavarotti?
Now everyone walk in a circle.
Bent up to you, kid.
Now this guy here, all right, the guy on the left in the little page boy out. He looks like a little doll that you can just pick up. Look at his legs, they're so straight. I laugh so much when I
wind him up.
Pomp and pageantry, everyone. Pomp and pageantry. Oh. I mean, he does.
Why did they have to pick the shortest man to wear that uniform? I just want to ask because it just makes it even funnier. I'm sorry, but...
Ask the question once more.
It does look like the jester.
Will you be the king?
Will you be the jester?
Yes, I will be the king.
Look at this lady's hat.
Lady of Fist.
Are you willing to do the same?
Lady Eilish? There's only one Eilish on there, and that's Billie Eilish.
No, this is Lady. This is
not really invited, is she?
This is her grandmother, Lady Eilish.
Lady Eilish.
Here we go. Walk the red carpet or bring it with you. Why not?
Take it everywhere you go.
Now, when I first saw these chairs, I won't lie. I thought they were little potties. They look.
Little porta potties.
And I was like, why are they not even facing the crowd? Why are they facing the wall?
Let's just say I'm sitting in the right chair.
It's funny because when me and my family first saw this, we had a joke. Because we've got so many different chairs in our lounge room, we said that it looked like our lounge room because everything was a different chair. There wasn't one crazy theme on that stage at one point ever.
Valuable thing that this world has to offer.
Oh, he's got a soothing voice, doesn't he?
This is the royal log.
The royal log?
The life
royal lord
of God.
Oh, look at that smile. You see that smile?
He's happy now. He's happy now.
But for about 5 seconds.
I have to say, I really felt for King Charles because he looked so scared and so nervous and on the edge. Like, I felt like he was going to cry any minute, and I just wanted to hug him.
Well, think about it like this. He didn't have the experience that George will get. He was there when he was 4 years old at his mother's, and that was the last time he ever saw it.
Yeah, but don't forget the fear. Look at him.
He's got a royal Bible on the thing there.
And he's enshrined in law.
What?
I got a royal Bible. It's got a royal Bible on there.
Again, they're very much embedded in Church of England and
Presbyterianism.
Yes.
Oh, what a moment.
It's very much a part of their royal families, even. You have to accept the Church of England to become the king or something like that. I remember my mum telling me.
Hey, hold on a second. This guy's using a cheat sheet.
To any of them belong.
It's got bloody cue cards.
Imagine, I would love that in a maths test. Just put the answers right there. Someone's just holding the answers for me. Like, sorry, I'm the king. I can do this.
It is the king's privilege to have that. I will say that, even though he's waited his whole life to for this one position.
He like goes to apply to become a doctor. I got the credit. What? I passed the test.
This guy's had 50 years.
I passed the test, all right.
Would it be wrong to say that I just want to hug him and just say, look, Your Majesty, everything's going to be okay. You're going to have a wonderful day. Don't think of anything
else. Imagine doing that to your grandfather. Like, Would your grandfather feel belittled in a way?
If you did do that, you would be arrested, Kat. Yeah. You would definitely be arrested, for sure.
He's definitely just older. He's not exactly fragile. He's been in this world for a long time. He knew what was coming. He's accepting it willingly. He's here. I think he's just a little bit lost because his mum used to do all this stuff, and now he has to take on the role of everything.
Yeah.
As by law established in England. And will you preserve unto the bishop?
Now, what we noted last night, his hands are swollen, most likely due to
sausage fingers.
Arthritis. I'm guessing that's what my mum had arthritis, and her hands used to get like that in the cold.
My fingers are not red. Look at this. Not good on my fingers.
The things which I have herebefore promised, I will perform and keep. So help me God.
Bravo, King Charles.
Leon provides sound effects.
To make and declare to the statutory accession declaration oath.
Where are we in our run sheet?
Why do I feel like he's about to go dunch? I'm the king.
I'm a faithful Protestant.
Imagine if Dwayne Johnson.
Protestant. That's it. Protestant, guys. That's the word.
The enactments which secure the Protestant succession to the throne.
Yeah.
Uphold and maintain the said enactments to the best of my powers according to law.
Mm.
Oh, he looked absolutely disgusted at that just then.
No.
Look at Camilla, not even looking in the direction. You see what I mean? She's absolutely daydreaming there. You don't have to smile. At least look in that direction to make it a bit more cohesive. Don't look like you're in La La Land.
Man, look how much ink's on that pen. Jeez.
Now, Charles has come out and said how much he hates fountain pens and feathers. Yeah. Feather pens. He hates them a lot, apparently. He prefers a normal pen, but...
Why didn't we just get him a biro? We could have just gotten him a biro. No one would have put one.
Because it's illegal to sign in a biro.
Are you kidding? We need the old typewriter.
Send a text message and be done with it.
Hey, in like 500 years from now, they bring out like the royal tablet.
The royal iPad.
It takes a face shot of them.
Yeah, we need a royal iPad.
Just sketch it.
Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Oh, everyone.
Now, everybody, all on your feet.
Put your left foot in.
Put your left foot out.
Put your left foot in, and the king will shake it all about.
Throned in heavenly splendor.
He will do the hokey pokey, and he'll wear the crown.
That's what royalty's all about.
On him such gifts of wisdom and love that we and all thy people may live in peace and prosperity.
Beautiful painting. I would really love to see the Abbey.
That's the Last Supper.
Lord, yeah.
With the Father and the Holy Spirit.
Have a look at the size of the candles.
Yeah.
One God.
It would be such an experience to go there and see this place in person. And just
isn't that one of those candles that blocked out Meghan Markle's view when she was sitting at the pew?
Royal. They purposely put it out there.
Oh, shit.
Here we go. The priest is bringing him his last rites. Sorry.
That's not nice.
No, it's not.
This is your last act as a free man.
They bring him out. Plague! 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 Why do they walk with it open like we can read from here? Like, what's the go with that?
Saint Augustine.
It's a spiritual book.
Pages are stuck together for some weird reason.
The question is why is he carrying it with a pillow?
Because it's more expensive than him. I told you.
Maybe it's too good for his hands.
The dean of the chapel.
You'll see soon that they put a glove on the king to touch something. And to hold something, that's because of the oils in the hands will damage it.
I think that's why he carried the Bible on the pillow and had it open.
Oh, crap, he's got double. The gospel. I only have one crack at this, and I gave it a double. Oh, well, screw it.
All right, here we go, repeat.
Sorry, fellas.
plague night.
I hope I've only got this twice. Imagine having this three times. That'd be amazing.
Imagine the whole video is just this.
This is on middle of Italy track.
I might as well try and read while I'm here. What does that say?
Double up.
That segment was so nice we had to say it twice.
Will be read from Saint Augustine's.
I hope it's only up here, like
the Royal Bible has arrived for its coronation. Everyone can relax now.
For a second time.
In Ukraine. Look, we're in the Ukraine flag.
This will be brought to a point where it can be
hopefully
read.
It's only up here twice, not three times.
Dean at the chapel.
I've been editing all
there
day.
There we go. It's moving on.
Hopefully. Oh, good.
Be with you.
Little Red Riding Hood.
Christ according to Luke.
Good to see she showed
looks
up.
Like a female version of John Denver.
Why do they look like they're wearing Star Wars robes? I'm.
The imagine playing the Imperial March inside the Abbey.
I see Darth Vader didn't show up today. That was rude of him.
I'm telling you, they plagiarized off John Williams. I swear.
Hey, they've got an orchestra and everything.
Place where it was written.
Prince Charles, I am your father.
There needs to be a lightsaber match. I'm sure of it.
He has sent.
She looks a female. This
lady looks like
Denver.
A really mean. Yes, also a female version of what's his name?
The blind.
Pope.
Elton John. Thank you.
And it seems to me he's lived his life.
That was us, 100%. Oh, here we go. All right, everyone have a quick read. All right, too late, sorry.
Bat down.
I reckon there's some witchcraft in that book.
That's all you get.
Not witchcraft, it's English.
Some sort of nonsense is definitely in that book, yes.
Come on, don't be slack. That's not nice.
Imagine some instructions on the Kama Sutra.
No, there is no Kama Sutra. Stop being disrespectful, Leon.
The Royal Kama Sutra, sorry.
Oh, here we go.
And
I love this.
I want to say something, but it would be so bad.
It's basically choir.
I can't say it.
Well, you're only going to see a couple seconds of this anyway. See, I believe in equality. I gave you a few seconds.
Hey, now this is what the coronation should be at. This was a performance. It's got vibes, all right? Look at their vibes. Look, even in their robes, they look sick as shit. Like, look at him. They're even vibing together. Their performance was different than the rest.
Nice.
These guys were actually singing at Prince Harry and Meghan's wedding happened last May.
Really?
Yeah, last May. I think in about 2 weeks, 3 weeks, they celebrate their wedding anniversary. And these guys were singing in the choir.
I still can't get over this guy's laser tag outfit.
To serve.
Really squeezed in there, like.
Oh.
They really said, "You're not moving your arms today, buddy."
This girdle must be killing me.
The arms cannot be lifted above the head.
Above waist height.
I just want to say those robes and outfits are quite literally heavy. They're not thin.
They would be. I can only imagine how much gold's actually on them.
I feel sorry for the royal droid having to wash about 6,000 of these.
I can tell you because I've experienced something like this. When it looks like he's in, they've covered him in a square shape. I can explain all that to you because I've witnessed it myself, and I can tell you exactly what's going on, bit by bit.
Thine only son was anointed by the Holy Spirit. To be the Christ.
Now, when I saw these three guys, I said the three wise men, and I had a bit of a laugh at that. I won't lie.
The three wise men, you mean Curly, Larry, and Mo?
They weren't wise.
Once the priest leaves, it'll just be these three stand together, and they look quite the trio.
They're holding
I'm just
on to
waiting for someone to go, nah, 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 nah.
They're actually holding on to a lot of gold, considering they're of the cloth.
Yeah, exactly, because one of them bought mirth, one of them bought gold, and one.
Although they are wearing a lot of cloth, so I guess you can, you know.
The anointing with.
Hey, that wasn't
they followed
the
start. They followed the start of the coronation.
This is what
here
I want
we
to
go.
Talk about.
The royal this screens is... are coming.
Okay,
in, guys.
Okay. Let me just say, I know what this is all about because I've seen it happen, witnessed before me in a church. This scene, however, let's just wait till they make it into a square, then I can actually explain to you what happens behind that. You and I have seen.
Well, she's explaining for the viewers. We all know, so.
Yes. Last time I saw it was kind of set up in the Simpsons. So this,
see how it's a square? My uncle last year, was it last year or this year? No, last year became a priest. He was a deacon for many odd years. And then in the church, they put this around him. What happens is they derobe him.
The art on the screens is beautiful.
Okay. They derobe him of his deacon clothes and dress him in his priestly outfit. So now they're derobing Prince Charles of his princely outfit. And then they'll get him to wear what looks like a priestly outfit, which is his
coronation. Look at that.
But technically,
that is a partridge in a pear tree.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Well, it's not even
if you notice this part,
embroideries. Kat, you've got to speak over all of us because we're all going to keep commenting at the same time. So just keep talking.
This part is where they dethrobe him of his princely outfit. Of his outfit that he came in the carriage with, and now they're going to dress him up. He looked like a priest, but it's his coronation outfit. That I know because my uncle came a priest, and that's how it went down precisely. And then my uncle kneeled as well, so you'll see King Charles kneel in a second. And that's exactly bit by bit, play by play, how it happened with my uncle as well. So basically, de-broke him and putting on the new outfit.
These kids are definitely sick of being here. They need a break.
I was trying to think, were the kids actually singing King Charles or just looping themselves? Sounded like it.
They actually sing it at different...
Oh my God, I said that last night. I said the same thing last night.
They sing it at different octaves and the sound that produces actually sounds like King Charles, but apparently they're not actually saying it.
What are they saying?
Like they're making sound that sounds... When it joins in, the octaves all meet and...
I believe what they're saying is rejoice, but it sounds like King's Charles. They're actually saying rejoice.
Yeah. Okay.
They were saying a bunch of stuff. I had the subtitles on when it happened. They were saying a bunch of stuff.
They've derobed him. Now they're putting on his priestly outfit, which is his coronation outfit.
That's probably his Elton John outfit.
Michael. See how he's kneeling? That's how my uncle kneeled. So he's receiving the blessing from God now, and the priests are blessing him. The archbishops and everything are blessing him. So this is actually the blessing.
At King Charles's age, imagine how long it would take him just to get up back on his feet after kneeling like that.
Look at the flags. They look nice there. That was a good spot for them. What about
the cramp? Again, I would have liked to have seen the Australian flag. It's nowhere to be seen.
It's there.
Actually, that's not true. We did see it in the beginning, but we haven't seen
it. It's there, right there in the church. It's there.
It is actually.
Hey, do you reckon Macaulay Culkin's in this crowd somewhere for Home Alone 10?
Sorry?
Macaulay Culkin.
Yeah, where's Macaulay?
Is he Canadian? I can't remember.
That's the point. See, now what they're doing is they're robing him. They're putting his new coronation outfit in. It's like a priest's outfit. My uncle had that.
Looks like he's wearing PJs.
Gold member.
You know, Kat's uncle George is actually king, just in case you didn't know. No, just kidding.
He was actually just dipped in the royal gold pot. He was first 16 carat. Now he's just been anointed to 24 carat gold. Being the king, he has to be the highest order.
I honestly want to hug him.
Look at this. This is beautiful. Ready?
Here we go.
There we go.
Well done, Your Royal Highness. Well done, William.
And just think, one day William is going to be there. That's going to be him.
Have a look at William's face. That robe is not going to fit
William. It's too short for William. He's very tall. I just realized. What the
look
heck?
Look like scout badges. That's what that looks like.
Yeah, but have a look at William's face right now. He's like, oh, shit, that's me next.
Yeah. Why does he look like a Viking right now? He looks
like... A
Viking? Viking.
A Viking.
Checking him for shoddies. That's what I'd be doing.
Well done, Your Royal Highness. Oh, William, you are literally...
Just let me clip you on, buddy.
So stoic and strong.
Here you go, Daddy.
Here you go, Daddy.
King Daddy.
King Daddy. That sounds even worse.
That's what they call him. They call their mum, mummy, and daddy. I think it's cute. I don't care if it's got that sexual stigma on the background of it. It's
don't even go there, okay? Don't even go there.
Here we go. He got to sit down. That's nice. I'd love that. That's a good moment. My friend in the uniform.
The orb.
That is one shiny ball.
Right hand.
That is the orb. The orb symbolizes that God has given him the power to reign. God has given him the power, and God watches the world and looks out on over the world. So God is actually protecting and looking out for the world.
Yeah, I'd also like to note that the weight of the orb is saying that the king has now this great weight that he has to take care of.
My allegiance goes to the lady holding the big ass sword. She.
Oh, here we go. Here's the glove.
She was. Oh, here we go. The royal bee glove.
The king's going to give a royal prostate examination.
Filled with bees.
that's
the test. They fill it with deadly bees, and if he survives the attack, he gets to become king.
Great. The king is in the building to check your prostate.
Jackson's other glove.
No glove, no love.
Michael Jackson. See what I mean? See, all these pop culture references could have been mentioned, and this coronation would have been the funniest thing that ever happened in my life. I would have loved it. I would have loved the king. I would have pledged allegiance to the comedy. That would have been it.
He's getting another scepter right now. He can go skiing with these.
And the rod of equity and mercy, a symbol of covenant and peace. May the spirit of the Lord who anointed Jesus...
That glove is so that the oils of his skin do not tarnish the gold or ruin it anyway, because after a lot of time of handling it, years and years, thousands of years, it actually erodes. So to keep it pristine, because these things cost so much and they're so ancient, they have to wear the glove.
That's a good point. I never thought about that.
Yeah. It's the same with our old paintings.
As we approach the moment of crowning with St. Edward's crown.
I heard the word chroming, not crowning, just then. That was
chroming. We're going to change the colours. Got to change the...
The moment of chroming. They spray paint like the...
They spray paint the carriage.
King Charles was here.
Just a heads up. Camilla's crown, they removed the diamond Koh-i-Noor from it, and they've kept it in the Tower of London, so you won't see the Koh-i-Noor on her crown.
Yeah, okay. It's very common for them to alter the crowns of the royals and change them around based on the royal themselves. I've heard that Queen Elizabeth had a lot of the crowns changed around with stones that she enjoyed and stuff like that.
I would just like to say that if it was only returned to the rightful owners of India, they could have wiped out India's poverty level. But that's just saying.
And that's just in saying that their government will actually use the money on them too.
Oh, did you see that? I saw a little jungle there with that crown.
Is. I want that on
Please put that on his head properly. Imagine if it was too big and it just sunk over his eyes. That'd have been amazing.
Well, it's fitted beforehand, so.
Yeah, it's fitted. They tested out. Yeah, he's had it.
That's what I was saying before. That robe is not going to fit William. William's like at least three times the size of Charles.
Three times the size?
Height-wise.
Wow. Yeah, I could feel that buzz right there. Oh, my God.
I wish I had that sound effect. Boom.
I love how they didn't put it on properly at first, so they had to take it off and do it again. And they're like, are you okay, Charles? Yes. He just like focused on
that movie. Apex. There you go. And the guns
are fire. There we go. There he is. In London. All in all of his glory.
All I can say is from Australia, God save the king.
God save the king.
Now it was annoying hearing that the Sydney Opera House did not light up for this coronation.
Uh-huh.
Absolutely outrageous.
Well,
yeah, because they didn't pay the power bill.
Maybe because Canberra did it, and because Canberra is the official state capital, then country capital, then maybe Canberra did it.
I mean, you think it'll make sense, surely.
They don't do it when stuff like something. They do it in respect for when they pass away and stuff like that. When he passes away, they'll light it up.
Wow, look at Princess Sophie.
Hey, you reckon
Catherine
there was starring the next Star Wars movie?
Catherine took away the show. Her outfit was stunning. Oh,
yeah. And Sophie, Countess Sophie, or shall I say the Duchess of Edinburgh?
Lord. Princess
Sophie, wow.
These hats remind me of the Christmas hats, guys.
The party hats.
Yeah. What color did you get? I got yellow. I got red. I got blue.
You realize how rare it's going to be to get a yellow one now because of this?
And faith and truth I will bear unto you, our sovereign Lord, defender of the faith.
Right here is where I looked at his face and I thought, he looks so sad. I can tell he's thinking about his mum right now. I can feel it.
So help me God.
Hug him. I have so much love and respect for King Charles.
Oh, here we go.
He comes all in. All right, this is my favorite part of all parts.
William.
Now do a break dance. Sorry.
Pledge my loyalty to you, and faith and truth I will bear unto you, as your liege man of life and limb. So help me God.
Now Charles did the same for his mother.
His father on the right cheek.
I would call that an investiture for sure.
Charles did the exact same thing at 4 years old.
That'd be like the most awkward kiss William would ever have to make in his life.
But why? What's so wrong about giving your parents a kiss on the cheek? That stigma needs to be broken. I know it's a stigma there, but it needs to be broken because that's like, I want to normalize being able to hug and give your parents a kiss on the cheek for thanking them for what they've done.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Here we go, the royal penis holder.
Can't say that. Well, you can, but...
Well, you can. It was direct, that's all. It was erect.
Well, at least Luna was straight to the point here.
Erect in salute of the king. Sorry.
I like how Carmilla's...
Look at this guy, the way he walks, like doot, doot, doot.
Here, the crown.
Here's your crown.
Here's your crown, GTFO.
Oh, for Benya. Better if Camilla's getting uncomfortable. Look how fast they did hers compared to his. They just put it straight on. They didn't even.
Yeah, here's your crown. Get out of here.
Put your hand down, Camilla. Put your hand down. Let them dress you. Don't touch it. Don't touch it.
No.
By thine abundant grace and with all princely virtues.
Her head is instantly itchy. She just wants to scratch the shit out of it.
Certain of thy protection.
Mate, I would hate to be like having an allergy to that kind of stuff on your head. You know, oh, I can't wear a beanie because it itches my scalp.
Yes. Touch your hair. Do not.
And they're like fur. They're like lined with fur and stuff on the inside. Imagine there's just some lady walking towards you and you're just holding two sticks in the air, sitting on a chair.
As you start singing.
This is the only moment this is appropriate. Anywhere else, this would be a laugh. Laugh riot.
Does look like she's on a deck chair.
Why does she look like she's on a deck chair and he looks like he's standing on something pink? What's going on?
It looks like a feeder on a block of cheese.
She looks so uncomfortable, doesn't she? You know when you put a little kid on an adult chair and their legs go back?
The legs start freaking.
Kicking them. Oh, he did it, guys. He got his arms above his waistline. Well done. Now this guy's got a book holder. Everyone's got a book holder in England, apparently.
I have to say, all these priests, they have soul.
That we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee.
Oh, I'm going to redeco my room tomorrow with this kind of stuff.
God. Yeah, I want that wallpaper for sure.
But instead of the 12 apostles, everyone's face is King Charles.
Isn't that creepy?
I will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
The oath.
Us this day our daily bread and
okay.
Forgive us our trespasses.
That's not true. They did. It's just that I saw him yesterday.
But deliver us from evil.
I'm sorry, but the outfits of everybody blew me away. The different countries, the different representations. It was so beautiful. I did notice that, though, they placed a lot of the ethnic people together in a row. I didn't like that. Why did they not separate them and place them in their respective areas?
Basically, ducks in a row.
Yeah.
My
I'm very proud right now to say God save the king. I really can't wait for him to come to Australia and maybe go down there and say, shake his hand and say hello. Because I think he's
probably got Buckley's chance at that.
These ones in the back are wearing giant hoodies.
I can't wait. I can't wait for His Majesty to come here. Oh my God. So many photos. I want to shake.
Now he's dressed
doesn't
purple,
this remind you guys of Flavor Flav? He's got a wine casket in one hand. He's got his walking cane in the other.
A gigantic clock here, though.
He's got his pimp stick in the other hand.
Pimp stick. Yeah, but the problem is he doesn't have a clock around here. He needs a clock somewhere around his chest.
We can sort that. Don't worry.
But if
a royal clock. A royal have, grandfather have clock because of his age.
Now. Have a look at his face. He looks so forlorn. I just want to hug him. All I want to do is just hug him. I know I'll get arrested, but I just want to hug him.
You can tell whatever he's wearing is heavy because he's struggling. You can see.
Looks like he's dressed like a polywaffle.
His flavor clock is on him right
now. But isn't it so weird the way we crown a new king is to by putting a bunch of metal on his head and then putting blankets around him and getting him to sign a piece of paper? Like,
what? Hopefully there's no lightning around, otherwise it becomes a lightning rod.
But do you know what? After appearing on the balcony, I have to say he must have taken that crown off and that robe off and gone, oh, thank God.
He must have gone to the bathroom and had something to drink and he felt a lot better. I would agree on that.
Well, if you're doing this for 1.5 hours, it is, age, you'd be busting to go to the toot real quick. Oh, it's not bad.
I mean, look how heavy.
I mean, to be honest, I wouldn't even be surprised if I've heard, like, on days like this, they're actually asked, this is going to sound really weird, guys, but they're actually asked to wear like nappies and stuff like that because, yeah, a lot of celebrities do it when they have long shoot days, they wear nappies. Yeah,
Donald Trump, anyone?
It's a well known, it's a trick in the industry, especially like if you've got a flight for 24 hours and you don't have time to even go to the bathroom, you wear a nappy on the flight so that you don't.
Donald Trump, anyone?
They got so much yellow, like even if they were, like you wouldn't tell.
Cat's cringing right now.
That's why they wear so many robes to hide the puffiness around their bottom. I'm joking.
Congratulations, Your Majesty. God
have
save
a look at King Charles. He looks like a Cadbury wrapper now.
We must take the magic carpet with us too.
I can show you the world.
I have to say congratulations to Prince George. What a remarkable young man. Like, he's done his country proud, he's done his grandfather proud, and his mother and sister and brother proud. He's done himself proud. What a perfect little guy, I have to say.
He's a good little kid. You know these capes, they remind me of the Flintstones. I don't know, I think it's the pattern, the polka dot pattern on the top. It reminds me of dinosaurs for whatever reason, but every time I looked at it, I'm like, Flintstones. That's the Flintstones.
No, that's easily Christmas pudding. Magic Christmas pudding.
Now bring me the figgy pudding.
You know what? I have to say, even despite it raining, he's going to make a great king. I can just feel it in my heart of hearts. He's going to be an exceptional king. A modern king. More relaxed.
Look at that frigging carriage, guys. That is lavishness beyond extreme. Not what needed. Unnecessary.
This carriage was actually made in Australia, guys.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, if it was made in Australia, that's not real gold. It's just spray paint gold.
What do you mean? We have the gold rush here, Leon. Come on. Give us the benefit of the doubt.
But that was like 200 years ago.
It is that old. It's very old.
Well, let's start it again.
24 carat gold. So there is a lot of gold. Gold leaves on it. So
exactly.
So it is a very expensive carriage.
Just absolutely unnecessary. They could have just made it black and painted it gold. It would have done the exact same thing.
Well, they didn't spray paint it chrome while they were inside the building.
Oh, but it did apparently have an air conditioner and it was made of bulletproof glass.
That's messed up, mate.
The carriage has air conditioner?
That's messed up.
It totally did, yep. And
on top of just hydraulics.
But it also had hydraulics as well.
Just get a bloody Pope mobile.
It's one of the most apparently even the Queen before her death said that carriage was really uncomfortable to be in, and it's just she said.
Wait! I'm sorry. Did you just say the Queen after her death?
Before her death, said that carriage was really uncomfortable. because the cushion inside where she's sitting isn't that comfy anymore. Like, don't forget, whoever made this carriage in Australia didn't think about it right.
This is all for show. What's the point of this? A black, I'm right. Sorry, but a black carriage would have done the exact same thing.
Look at those. Where's our flag? All I see is the Jamaican flag.
Ring out here in Broad Pavement, and a bit of reaction as the carriage joins this.
We're going to be flagged.
This is the only part about I'm jealous about living. The only reason, right there. The only reason I'm jealous about not living in England is I would love to be a part of one of these parades. I'd love to be there and witness it and just be a part of the crowd.
I say, you know what? The four of us in 5 years, in 10 years time, go and see, because that's when King William will be king. I say 5 to 10 years. If we save up for 5 to 10 years.
His mother bloody lived to 90 something. You got another 20, 30 years, mate, I'm telling you.
No. He's 75 this year. 10 years will be 85. Another 20 years will be 95.
So let's pretend he lives to 95. That's 20 years.
Yeah, he got about 15 years, I think. Probably best. He waited all his life to be the king for 15 years.
Well, Elizabeth had to be the queen for her whole life. She didn't get her youth, did she? He got to at least have his youth. So he should be happy.
State entrance where members of...
And there goes the cart.
Dun, 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 dun.
Dun, 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 dun.
I see the hair extensions have been following. There we go.
And of course, this thing wouldn't be complete without them standing up
and
on
now,
the balcony.
And now the gate shuts and they never talk to us again because they don't really know us.
Charles III and Queen Camilla.
Respectively, I had a lot of struggle, a lot of time struggling with the fact that there were so many people on the balcony this time. I'm used to the normal amount of people up there, the 7 or 8 of the immediate family. I now realize that Camilla's family is going to be up there a lot too. It's just a lot to swallow, and it's hard to... so recently, after the Queen has already passed away, now we've already got another Queen. Like, it doesn't...
So.
I don't know.
And Camilla is.
And there you guys go.
It's just different.
Helped her with her train and doubtless steadied the nerves too this morning as she was getting ready.
Now, Harry should have been here.
Yeah, he wasn't, unfortunately. He went to Heathrow. That's what I understand. He went to Heathrow.
Yeah, but shouldn't both sons have the right to stand at the balcony despite the fact that what he said in those interviews in that book, he's still his son?
He might, you know what, guys, let's give them the benefit of the doubt here. Maybe he was invited and he declined.
He was 2 years old when he was first on this balcony.
He was sort of 2 or 3. I mean, Queen came out as a baby. There we go.
And that's it.
There we go.
Oh, wow.
That was amazing. Thank you so much for joining us. Hope you like this video. Let us know in the comments below what you think and of our banter. Don't forget to subscribe. Click the bell icon because that'll give you more content from all of us as we are racing in time behind the scenes, working tirelessly for all of you to bring more content. I am Kat. This is Buckets. Luna and Leon, thank you so much. Good night, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. Stay safe. Until then, we will see you next week. Broadcast race.
Cheerio. Bye. Cheerio.
Bye.